Welcome to the Honeyville Kitchen. I am Chef Tess, and today we are making Thai chicken in a spicy peanut sauce. It is a fantastic family-sized, shelf-stable meal in a jar that includes the chicken, spicy sauce, everything you need, including the rice for it to go on top of. So let's just jump right in and make this meal in a jar. I'm excited. The first thing that you're going to need is a cup and a half of freeze-dried chicken. Freeze-dried chicken is already cooked and chopped and shelf-stable up to 15 years, so this is a great thing to have on hand when you're making meals in a jar. The next thing that we're going to need is a half a cup of soy sauce powder. For our sauce, we are making the spicy peanut sauce right here at the bottom of the jar. The next thing we need is 2 tablespoons of lemonade powder. Just real quick, that's gonna give it that tart, lightly sweet, beautiful oriental flavor. And then one thing I really like in my Thai food is a lot of garlic. You can control how much you like, but personally, I love a full tablespoon of minced garlic in there. It gives it beautiful, strong garlic flavor, which I really like. The next thing we need is a third a cup of, for peanut sauce, we would need peanut butter powder. So peanut butter powder, third a cup of that, right in there. And that will be nice and creamy when it's hydrated. You're gonna love it. And a third a cup of freeze-dried, or you can also use dehydrated, freeze-dried or dehydrated onions, and 2/3 a cup of dehydrated carrots. The thing I love about Honeyville's dehydrated carrots is they are puff-dried, so when they hydrate, they just have a really beautiful carrot flavor. Okay, there's gonna be a lot of powder. You're gonna shake that down into that jar. We're going to maximize as much space as possible. So let's finish up getting our sauce together. We're also going to need a tablespoon of dry cilantro. That is sometimes called Chinese parsley, but what that does is it really gives you a beautiful, authentic flavor. And then we also are going to need, for a spicy Thai sauce, something spicy. So personally, I love it to be pretty hot, so I use about 1 teaspoon of red pepper flakes. You don't have to use that much, but something to give it a little bit of heat. And then my other personal favorite is using my Chef Tess Amazing Wok Star in there, and what that will do is it will make it very deep and give it some good bold oriental notes. Okay, so far we've got our sauce. Oh, you know what? We want our sauce to have some body to it. So we are going to be using some Ultra Gel today. Ultra Gel is basically a modified cornstarch, and it is non-GMO and gluten-free. So it's a really great one to add. Okay, now our sauce is in there, it's ready to go. We need the rice that it's gonna go on top of. So go ahead and just take a regular sandwich bag, put that right into your jar, just like that. And then you're gonna need 1.5 cups of rice, just right in there. And then I push it in there, so I'm sure I get everything. I maximize the space in my jar. Very important. Twist it closed. Now you're going to need an oxygen absorber packet in all of your meals in a jar, especially the ones with meat. Go ahead and put that right on there. So slide your lid on, just like that. Twist it on tightly. And what's going to happen is that oxygen absorber is going to go to work. It's going to absorb all the oxygen in there and make it a shelf-stable meal that's good 7 to 10 years on this one. So that's a really long shelf life. We love that. So let's see. What if we go ahead and make this just so we're sure it's something we would want to eat? I think it is. So this one is already made. And when you're going to prepare your meal, what you're going to do is take 3 cups of water in a pan for your rice, and then just go ahead and pour the rice right into your pan as it comes out. Easy stuff. Okay, there's that. And then all the stuff for your sauce will go in the next pan. So, just so you can see, it's kind of cool that it's all powder. And then it comes together to be such a delicious meal. And this is 3 cups of water. And I like using my jars because it's graduated right on the side and you can tell exactly. 3 cups, oh, good to go. Just add water. How amazing is that? Okay, let's take it to the stove. Try not to wobble too much. Okay, I'm gonna go high on that. And they both take about 20 minutes to cook, so make sure you put a lid on it. And come back in 20 minutes. And dinner will be ready. That's exciting. Okay, are we ready to cook this? I am. We have just taken 3 cups of water and added it to our rice and put it here in our pan. Oh my gosh, it's fluffing up, it's getting ready. And 3 cups of water in a separate pan to cook our remaining ingredients. You can see the chicken is really starting to hydrate and get beautiful. And when it is done, it is the most amazing Thai dish. Yum. So excited. Okay, let's give that about 10 more minutes and then let's dig in. Okay, I am so excited. Oh, the smell is just amazing. So go ahead and we're gonna dish up our rice. It's nice and fluffy and beautiful. Ready for a Thai dish. And I think the thing to keep in mind is this much food came from this little jar. Pretty amazing. We're gonna add our sauce. It's thickened up so nicely to that. Right on top. And then I personally love to put some sesame seeds on there. It's really nice. Okay. Are we ready? I'm so excited. Dinner. Beautiful. Hot, sweet, smoky, peanut, perfect balance of flavor. You're gonna love this meal in a jar. Go ahead and get it. If you are interested in any of the delicious products you have seen here today, come visit us at honeyville.com.